We're going to start a new project, me and my granddaughter, Seryiana. Today I've got a winged lion, which is a griffin. I picked it up at the thrift store. And we're going to...
And I have a book stand.
See the high gloss? So I'm going to go ahead and spray a layer of just spray paint.
This is $3.99 from the thrift store.
And this piece here was $7.99.
Good deals, they're really pretty.
Yes, yeah, and when you see what we're gonna do with these, you will be impressed. We're gonna take it back all the way to the natural concrete stage so that it looks like it's just been chipped and carved.
The ancient times.
Ancient time.
It's paint, so you always wanna shake it before you spray or else it will run out of the air in the can and it won't work.
Good? Light film to knock down the high gloss ceramic and allow the acrylic paint to stick.
So it's the next day and we're going to finish our statues. So we're going to be painting colors. I'm going to be painting mine green and black.
Here are your gloves.
A couple of my favorite colors.
I'm going to mix up a little baby powder. I could have used cornstarch, but don't breathe this in, Seryiana.
Okay.
It's nice working outdoors because you can make a mess and get plenty of fresh air. Yeah. Add a little Elmer's glue.
Good.
Okay, for me, I'm going to do a concrete type finish on my griffin. And definitely going to stick a lot better.
Probably.
So we have our textured paint here. I wanted to use actual concrete, but when I went to look for my concrete, it must have gotten thrown out.
Oh, hi, Becca.
Kitty, kitty. So I'm just going to do a thin layer, basically just to get my griffin covered. Color that I like.
Do I just dip the brush in?
Yes, the sponge, yes.
Really bright.
Yes, we've got the sun in our eyes.
So the blue might show. Blue is a pretty color.
So here I'm just getting it on. I'm not going to stress about color variation or padding motion so much at this stage, but we do want some added texture.
So I'm doing a play in drama at school, and this kind of reminds me of ancient Greece, sort of, the horse, you know? I feel like the horses were a big thing back then.
Ancient times, that was our mode of transportation.
Yeah.
Horses. And what were those carts that the Greeks would use, those chariots?
Yeah. Yeah.
Chariots, huh? Wow. So this is coming along just great. I love the bumps and the added texture that this is getting. Seryiana's green.
Makes a little.
Yeah. and I'll mix my own color.
Yeah, good idea.
Yeah.
And if you want to go for green, just add like black or something.
Yes, I could do that. I think a little black would be good because...
Yeah, that's very good.
Alright, good idea. Okay, so I'll go ahead and add more texture. A little black too. A lot. Okay. That's good. I don't want to go too heavy. But we are building up our texture.
Okay, I'm going to start adding the texture now. After we got the coat on, so I got all the black paint on the sponge. It's pretty. Okay, that should work.
Okay, I'm adding some dark here.
I'm trying to start.
To highlight.
I feel like it'd be cool if I like do a lightning bolt somewhere.
Oh, a lightning bolt.
Yes.
Okay, well. Oh, that's pretty already with that.
Okay, I'm also gonna go gold border. Just to try and get at this one. Just to like when I do the lightning bolt, I'll probably do the should I do the lightning bolt? What color? Like extremely bright green or like pastel green.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Or like yellow.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like it'd be cool like right here. What's this? Okay. Okay, then I
so in the play that you're doing, what character are you playing?
I'm props.
Oh, you're doing props?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Okay, so what do you do with your props?
We just create props, order props, do like cool stuff, because it's supposed to look like an ancient, like, Rome time.
Uh-huh, the Romans.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so you're helping with the stage set.
Yeah, pretty much. We just, like, move everything around. It's a, we're doing this play with, like, eighth graders. Drama's, like, my favorite class.
Yeah, well, why aren't you acting in any of the, scenes? Will you do that, maybe, or are you
probably
just going to stick to props?
Oh, okay. I've stage fright.
A little stage fright?
Yeah. I passed out. Last time I was on stage, I passed out.
Yeah, you did pass out, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, better to stay behind the scenes and get the whole, what would you say, vibe or the...
Yeah.
Yeah?
It's just really cool to watch. There's a cool scene with Zeus and Hera.
Oh.
Where there's lightning and stuff. It's so fun.
So how are you getting the lightning effect? Are you using strobe lights or?
Yeah, lighting.
Lighting?
Oh. And then sound. It looks exactly like lightning.
Oh, wow.
My first color. I guess some spots I didn't notice.
And which color was, oh, here it is.
Oops.
This is the concrete gray color.
Can I use some of that maybe?
Like for that? Absolutely. I won't be needing as much. So maybe that's enough for you to take the same sponge. The part with doing this kind of art is you just keep going until you're happy.
I'm trying to make it look like it's like old though.
Yeah, you're doing Aesop's Fables?
Yeah.
Oh, awesome. That's going to be great on your resume.
Because I love acting. I'm in a movie right now, you know.
I know, yeah.
Horror movie. But I'm scared if there's like a whole bunch of people. Like, I can do it if I'm on film, like right now.
Look at that lightning bolt. You just popped that in, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's gorgeous. Yeah. And
I'm gonna do more blending on it, of course.
Really? Oh, I think it's getting close, huh?
I can hold it by myself, it's fine.
Okay, yeah, because my shoulder is just so weak.
Mine hurts too.
Yours is hurting too?
Yeah, I don't know what happened. It's from class. The chairs are so uncomfortable.
Oh my gosh, you poor children are being tortured having to sit in those desks. With masks on, you're wearing your mask, right?
Yeah, of course. I'm not vaccinated yet.
Yeah, so you...
I'm not old enough. I'm 11. You know, 12. 15, 12.
Oh. Okay, so... got a little time.
Do you like it?
I love it.
So we're using some deco seal.
All right, so we're gonna
delay it kind of.
So since the paint is a little bit wet, we're gonna go ahead and use our fingertips. I know it's not the best. Seryiana has her gloves on. But I'm gonna go ahead and do the patting motion. Get the sealer on. So while the paint is still slightly wet.
It's so the...
so that it'll penetrate
and it won't, the acrylic won't peel.
Yes, it's gonna hold the acrylic, make it 10 times stronger.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we've got a party to go to tonight,
four,
huh?
10. Four of them. The party starts at 5.
Yeah.
So we're good on time.
It's Ben's birthday, my son-in-law. Well, I don't know how old he is, but we're having tacos. He's what? Turning what?
30.
No, 30?
Yeah, I'm not mad.
Okay. No.
That's what Emily has said.
Okay. He could be turning 30, but I don't know. I don't think so. But it's definitely adhered.
Okay, we are good.
You're done?
Yeah.
For now, and then we'll come back for it. We'll give it a...
my hands feel wet, but they're not.
Yeah, that's... yeah, those poor doctors and nurses having to wear those gloves. We've got a party to go to. I'm going to help make some guacamole and salsa for the tacos, and it's going to be fun.
Yeah, we're having a taco.
Happy birthday, Ben.
Yeah, happy birthday. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell while you're at it.
How well you have them blended, it looks antique.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm trying to go for. Okay, so I'm going to dip it into this pretty gold paint.
And with me, I'm going to do an eye on my griffin, and I'm going to try to do this lion eye, just so that it has character. So I'm going to do the white paint for the eye first.
I have like an idea of like, if I do like a cloud right here, like a small one.
Oh, wow.
The lightning bolt coming out, and like put pearl powder on it.
Okay.
Does that sound pretty?
Yeah. Yes. Give it a little hue, purple hue. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna lighten up the area so then when I do go with my natural colors, it's gonna pop. Oh, the cloud, yes. Yes, and you can highlight it. Get the cloud white, and then we'll go ahead and shadow it.
So I'm just adding like this pearly kind of look around it. Go ahead. Go all purple shiny.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Iridescence.
adding a little detail in here, like putting black in the center. I'm putting like this cool thing down the center of my house's face, like a stripe, because the movie that we were working on, we did the photo shoot at a ranch, and the horse there, one of the horses, had this really pretty like black stripe around, like down its face, like that.
Wow. Is he going to be in the movie?
I don't know. There's lots of horses in the movie, pretty sure.
You drew it today?
Yeah, earlier.
Now you did that?
Yeah. Don't mind that. I was just doodling.
That's a doodle?
On the side, yeah.
Oh, okay. Wow. I love those colors.
What's today's date?
Let's see. 11-11. 21. And I think you have a lot of the artist spirit in you because you just do it. You know, you're not trying to be perfect, you're just trying to enjoy. This is what she has so far. Look at that. Woo! Just gorgeous. I like this. It's got a little golden hue everywhere now.
Okay, so we are doing
the final touches.
The final touches. So I'm using some clear coat for the lightning bolt on my horse. That.
Yeah,
just. Am I using the clear coat for it?
And I'm going to use the clear coat for his eyes just to give it some dimension. When it dries. But yeah, we finished all of our design work here with our product and our piece.
Yeah, a nice clear coat.
Look at how beautiful it came out. That is so inspired. I cannot believe the amount of texture that she's got. And the glitter shows to be just perfect. I wish I would have put glitter in my piece, but look at that with the shine of the purple powder mix that we used, pearl pigments. Different color paints and our baby powder mix.
It started off with green and black.
It looks very.
I know, green and black with the gold highlights and the purple pigments. It just. You cannot find this in a shop.
Very beautiful.
I know. they're just, I mean, what a difference from that store-bought statue to something that you create.
It's still black and shiny. No,
yeah, with that glaze, that ceramic glaze. And now this is just so unique. Get creative, do artwork with your family, get them involved.
Yeah.
Make sure you guys like and subscribe and turn on that notification bell to see when she posts next. Bye, have a good night or day.
From my heart to your heart.